I'm Jia Min Chin. I'm an associate professor at the University of Vienna in the Faculty of Chemistry. When I was a child growing up, I really wanted to be an explorer, I wanted to be an astronaut, I wanted to be a scientist, anything that could push the boundaries and would let me learn more, explore, do crazy things. I learned how fascinating chemistry was when I was in high school, so that's when I first got in contact with chemistry. And then I realized how beautiful it was because you learn about these building blocks, these atoms that make up life, and then how they come up into molecules and so on. And so then I went to university and I fell in love with the subject. So what fascinates me most is how important structure is to how an object works. So one object that I think is a good representation is this seashell here. So this material, it's mainly made of calcium carbonate, and that is essentially the same material as chalk. But unlike chalk, which as we know is notoriously brittle, we have this and we can hit it and it doesn't break. And it all comes down to the structure of these materials, from the molecules all the way to what you can actually see with your naked eye. So what I do in the lab is that we weigh out different chemicals, we make new materials, we grow these beautiful crystals, but they're really, really tiny. So they're about, let's say, 50 times smaller than the diameter of a strand of hair. But then we can look at them under the microscope and try to control them using electric fields to make them assemble into something you can see. So it's like Lego blocks that make this beautiful dance, and they come together and they create a structure that we hope will be useful. My day typically starts out with a bunch of meetings, but in between I always kind of sneak into the lab or go and talk to my students, because that's the fun part of my work, kind of seeing them. Sometimes they're frustrated, sometimes they're really excited. And that's the nature of research. Most of the time, there's a lot of failures, but every now and then, you see like a spark of joy or a spark of excitement because they've discovered something. And that, for me, makes it all worth it. After a long day, usually I sit in my garden or I walk around, and it helps me to relax because then I remember, like, you know, all the beauty, all the cool stuff that one can observe. It's to kind of learn lessons from nature and to share some of the beauty and the joy that I get from it with students and with the general public.